There are lots of different types of robots. Insect robots, animal robots, jellyfish robots, toy robots, cooking robots, military robots, sex robots. An android is a human-like robot. It looks like a human, talks like a human, it acts like a human. Androids are the pinnacle of robotics and artificial intelligence. Successfully building an android is essentially like creating synthetic life in our own image. So how close are we to building an android? Right now, there are only a handful of robots that are anywhere close to passing themselves off as human. Not only do these bots look and feel weird, their artificial intelligence systems aren't that intelligent. But roboticists and computer engineers are working on humanoid intelligent robots all over the world. Why? Because who doesn't want a robot cook, butler, or driver? But making science fiction a reality is way harder than it looks. Even just attempting to make robots look and move like humans is hard.
Quiet, please. I'm doing the talking.
AI has gotten very smart in specific aspects, most recently in perception. You have speech recognition and as well as image recognition software on your cell phones. One of the pieces which AI is not still very good at is things like grasping and manipulation of physical objects. Things like cooking actually requires enough fine motion skills that it will at least need 10 years.
You have now more sophisticated robots that can pick and move around and help you more as a complement to the human capabilities rather than replacement.
I'll be very glad to tell my story.
So robots can't physically cook you dinner and clean up afterward yet. Even though most of the robots you see online are more like this, we're not actually that far from robotic limbs that perform basic movements. In the last 10 years, bionic prosthetic arms have come a long way. Many models have decent grip strength and individual finger articulation, but they're still controlled by people.
We don't fully understand how our muscles work. It's a complicated system that robotic technology can help to unravel.
So that's where we are with movement. But right now, that's kind of the best we got. And when it comes to the looks department, we are really far away. Synthetic robot skin is made of things like silicone and polyurethane. It still can't bounce back or feel things. As you probably know, it doesn't even look real. Realistic synthetic skin will need to be sensitive to different tactile experiences like heat and cold, and no one is even close. As for a humanoid robot with clever AI, a robotic skeleton, artificial limbs, and flawless skin, that could take decades or longer.
We'll have better sensors. Sensor meaning cameras. Smaller, higher resolution, faster, detecting what's out there. But it's not only visual, it will be auditory, it will be tactile. Fingers, hands.
One, two, three.
All he lacks is a heart and a brain.
Maybe we're overthinking this. Do we really want or need robots to be humanoid like the replicants in Blade Runner? Or would we be happy with them being out of sight like the disembodied voice on Star Trek?
Program complete.
If you want a household robot that sort of walks from one room to other, then you are probably looking for something that looks humanoid. But if on the other hand, you're looking for a smart home, and you know, food just appears in front of you, that's a smart home, not a smart robot. In terms of the challenges, they're the same. It's as to which one you prefer is really an issue.
What it's really all about is the task. Androids are great for working around the house, but several companies are already proving we don't necessarily need a humanoid robot to drive a car. Perhaps the most important obstacle to overcome isn't physicality or looks. If we really want intelligent robots to work for us, we're going to need to get them to work with us.
To be an effective assistant, you really need to be able to read the other person's mind. That's the whole entire direction that's actually happening right now. And in fact, there is this whole saying that the reason humans have the huge brains that we have is not to run away from the tigers in the savannah, but to deal with each other.
So what we need is to find a way not only to make robots act human, but for them to fully understand and even anticipate what's on our minds. And isn't that what we really mean by intelligence? What is intelligence anyway? How do you test it? How do you know when a thing is intelligent?
Intelligence involves things like perception, things like ability to manipulate the world, emotional intelligence, social intelligence.
That process of how you deal with the never seen before, never heard before, never experienced before, and still you somehow know how to react is something that we don't understand.
It'll be at least 25 years or more before we reach human-level intelligence. And if we do reach human-level intelligence, then we would have also passed Turing test.
Alan Turing is often referred to as the father of modern computing. He said a computer would deserve to be called intelligent if it could deceive a human into believing it was human. But anyone who's ever chatted with a bot online knows that they are not great. They don't always understand, they're repetitive, they don't respond in the way that a human would, or they know things that no human would know off the top of their heads.
There was this one human being who knew so much about all the arcana of Shakespeare that people essentially decided that it must be a machine because nobody with a real life would know so much about Shakespeare.
To be or not to be, that is the question.
Robots are a-coming, and while they may not be in humanoid form, they will be replacing the work of humans across our society. Blue collar, white collar, nobody is safe.
The reality is that anything routine, whether it is cognitive or non-cognitive, is going to be replaced. So for example, truck driving is something that within 5 years, it's probably going to be gone.
Radiologists, you got 5 years. Psychologists, we have an app for that. Sports and economics reporters, too late. Computers already do that job. Paralegals, bye. So how close are we to creating androids? Smart AI systems already exist, and we're a decade away from building robots that move like us. Though aesthetically, we've still got some major challenges to overcome. There's really no incentive to put all the pieces of the intelligent humanoid robot puzzle together, at least not yet. But in reality, we are not building toward a future where one type of artificially intelligent robot will exist. For better or for worse, we're heading toward a world where a whole fleet of specialized robots will be developed, each taking over its own little world. How close are we to getting you to subscribe? It's easy, just tap this button. So at the moment, AI isn't great, but part of that might be that AI just doesn't have its own memories. So what if we gave AI the ability to remember, to think back? Find out in this video here. And thanks so much for watching Seeker.